What's up, family? You back with another YouTube video. And today, we doing advice for freshmen. Even though there might not, actually, it's the option. If you want to go to school or not, it might, like where I stay, but depends where you go, if you're going to school or not. But without further ado, let's get into it.
All right, so first thing, first tip for the video, don't eat school lunch. Now, for me, this was a big one. This was really my problem in middle school. And to be honest, you just don't want to do it because it'll fuck up your stomach for like, damn it, for years, bro. Like, that shit fucked up my stomach for so long. I'd have random stomach aches. Like, it was horrible. Like, they gave us like these nasty pizzas with this disgusting cheese. I don't even know how I ate it. Like,
and chicken sandwiches, bro. Oh my,
yes, them bitches was pink. Bro, if you're going to eat anything pink, from school. If you're gonna eat anything from school, eat the fruit, but don't eat the. Please,
Bro, you better check every day. These pineapples be having hairs on them, bro. Like,
Oh my god, yeah, so that's why. See, bro, because the lunch ladies, they not actually eating the food. They going to Chick-fil-A. I remember I was in the morning for break after breakfast. Like, you know, you can. So like, I went to the bathroom, right? Like, you know, you probably seen it before, like all the lunch ladies at the lunch table eating their breakfast and lunch and stuff like that. I come by, I see they got Chick-fil-A, McDonald's, homemade lunch, right?
Man, and then, they don't eat that shit. They just prep it.
And then it's like,
get that bitch out of the freezer.
It's like, for me, I gotta eat this nasty ass full lunch because I'm too lazy to make a lunch in the morning. Like, nah. Look, Gavin, he went a lot of days without eating lunch. Me, I just started bringing lunch. Just make you a sandwich in the morning or something. Bring a bag of chips, and don't eat so much during the day.
I was dang near intermediate fasting, bro. Intermediate fasting in that bit, bro.
Oh god,
I would not eat nothing.
Man,
the only thing I eat was some. And I started bringing my lunch. Like the days I didn't, bro, I did not eat that shit, bro. Heck no. It didn't even mess with my stomach, but that stuff is just nasty. Depends what they have in them days, but still, don't chance it. Bring your cyclones from home and be happy.
Yep. Okay. That's it for tip number one. Remember, don't eat school lunch.
Tip number two. I'm my freshman out there, listen up. Teachers for middle school. We'll try to hype up high school like it's the hardest thing in the world. Just let that go the one day and not the other. That stuff is completely false. The first day of high school for me, we came in there, lights off, music blasting. Of course, they can't play no, you know, can't play no rap. But some people, some teachers actually do play rock music, but censor that bit. But it's not as bad as you think. The freedom in high school is so much different from middle school. In middle school, me and Nate went to this strict middle school, bro. I'm telling you, they're training us like we was the next Marines. Like they had us like in uniforms from like my sixth grade year to the eighth grade year, like 3 years straight uniform.
Yes, and the sixth grade year.
The blue.
I wasn't at school in sixth grade, but didn't y'all have to wear like, y'all could only wear like black or white shoes or something like that?
Oh my god. Yes, we got to wear black, white, or blue shoes. Like, bro, what? What? They were trying, bro. This was jail. This was jail, bro. I'm telling you, this was jail. There was time in the bathroom breaks if you wanted to go to the bathroom. Like, bro, what? Come on now. We had to wear belts, we had to tuck in our shirts. Man, high school.
Like, let me tell you how free high school is.
I seen girls in goddamn bathing suits in high school. They do not care.
Bro, literally, I had all A's and one B in high school, and I skipped. Bro, I have like, what, 10, 15 tardies? Missed like,
I've seen the 10 videos.
Classes. Like,
we've been skipping.
Yeah, so we skip a lot. We skipped a lot, and I still ended up with hella good grades, so it's really easy. You just gotta do your work. And
we
gotta
did that in 10th grade.
Yeah, 10th grade. We did that in 10th grade. We're supposed to be quote-unquote harder, but it's not hard. You just gotta do what you gotta do. It's really not hard.
Facts. Like, bro, the freedom, take it to none, my nigga. Like, You can, bro, you can leave the classroom when, not whenever you want, but the leniency on you, if you need to leave the classroom, they don't care. It's only affecting you if you're trying to go do something bad. Like, they did there to get paid. But that's my top, that's my number two right there.
Tip number three, use protection. Please, please. There are so many people who ruin their life over something so dumb and so easy.
So many.
Like, please, bro, just put, wrap it up, bro. It is not that hard. Really, they have so many forms of birth control. It's crazy how y'all have kids now. Like,
it's crazy. Makes no sense.
Like, there are so many options. I'll put some options
for you. I think y'all just want the baby at that point.
Like, bro, it's like you got the plan B. You got so many different types of condoms. Like, I didn't even know. I didn't even know about some of these, bro. Like, it is really not that hard.
And I just found this out. If you're 16 and up, you could just walk in this store and buy you a pack. You don't gotta be shameful. Hey, bro.
Because look, the reason why they don't make it illegal is because they'd rather you like, it's like, they're not gonna stop teenagers from having sex, right? But if they can at least be like, okay,
they're gonna encourage safe sex. Because
they know they're not gonna stop y'all. Y'all just gotta use protection. I'm gonna keep harping on that. Use it, bro. It is not that hard. Because there are some people walking around with all types of infections. Actually, I ain't gonna say that, but some people walking around with kids, all types of shit, no future. Like, bro, don't let
no future. Your life is done.
Like, bro, don't let a kid.
Now you gotta live a life for somebody else at that point. Like, do not do that to yourself. Like, do not limit your days. Like, bro, you got free education, and now you can't even go to school for half. Because you pregnant and got these symptoms, yada yada yada, because you know you don't want to go to school and you pregnant, and then the dad, most likely in high school, that dad is not staying. I'm telling you, I'm gonna keep it real on this channel. These dads in high school, baby dads, there's only one reason they had that baby with you, just to get a little satisfaction in his life. You ain't gonna really keep that baby. I mean, take care of it. That's just more pressure for y'all females. So just be mindful in your heads. When that time comes, make sure that person has protection on them, or you do one or the other.
So yeah, guys, tip number three, use protection. We'll get on to the next tip.
Tip number four, guys. Build a great relationship with your teachers and stand out day one.
Yes, sir.
You want that open house. You come in there, you don't got to be kissing they buttocks, bro. You don't got to do all that. But just show some respect to the teacher. He or she's going to be your teacher for the year, my guy. So just keep that in mind. Be respectful. Be nice. Be courteous. Respect other people.
Then look, depending on the teacher, you can do more or less. It just depends on how cool the teacher is. You can get away with a lot, but you just gotta make sure you're not being loud and annoying. As long as you're not being loud and annoying, you can get away with a lot of stuff. If the teacher is
problems,
cool. You just gotta know.
Do your work.
As long as you're doing your work and you got at least like, if you're passing the class, the teacher is not gonna care. Because the teacher, as long as you're passing the class, he did his job. He or she did it.
That's literally every teacher. They don't, bro. You can be on your phone, all that, bro. Like, they don't care. If you pass in that class, they did their job, like Nate said. They did their job. They passed one kid on. Now, that's all you really got to worry about. Just worry about yourself. Like, don't do too much. Just worry about yourself.
But, tip number four, get good with the teachers, stand out in a good way. All right. Tip number five, be social, not annoying. So what I mean by that, when I say be social, not annoying, go out and talk to people. It's okay to talk to people. It's okay to talk in group projects. You don't got to go straight to the back corner of the classroom. But you see, when you're coming to high school, it's like your eighth grade friends are coming with you. So you're going to know a lot of them people. But don't be afraid to make new friends, because you
be
never
honest,
know.
Be honest, guys. Nine out of 10 chances. You're not really going to have the people in eighth grade that you had in your classes. you're gonna have to adapt, make new friends. Like, come on now. Don't be that person that's always to himself. You don't wanna go to high school that way. You wanna have a good experience. Like, you know, just come there, get that grade, be friendly to people. You don't gotta be buddy, 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 all that, but you know, just make friends with people that fit your criteria.
But what Gavin said, all that is true. But what I meant by being not annoying, or just not being annoying. So like, these are people that like try to talk too much, or like are loud, always disrupting the class type. This is annoying people. And then it's like, you're making these jokes, you're making the same joke over and over again, and you're just not funny. That's annoying. Okay, me and Gavin have experienced this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look, I'm not trying to say too much, but we could say I'm a bit of a trendsetter at my school. Okay, there are a lot of people that annoy me so much, trying to be like me. And I'm not saying, if you're watching this video,
these are people.
I'm not saying it's you.
These are people we're cool with, actually. Like,
yeah, but like, some people just try to be me, and it's so annoying because I'm pretty outgoing at school. So a lot of people just try to be like, I don't know. I'm not trying to say too much, but please do not be that guy. Please find your own mojo, your own niche, your own way of acting, because being a follower is so annoying. You don't have to stick up. You don't have to kiss nobody's ass, bro. Just be yourself.
Oh, I hear all facts right there.
But yeah, y'all, that's tip number 5. Be social, not annoying. And we'll get to tip number 6.
Tip number 6. This is piggybacking pretty much of what the last section of tip 5 said.
This is a big one, guys. Because
we had this happen. Big Nate. Bro, let me just say this right here. Nate, he's gonna really relate to this one heavy, because somebody, and he knows, he had like 2 classes with him, tried to do this a lot. Do not try to fit in. Oh my goodness. Do not try to fit in with any crowd. I don't care. Good, bad, sad, ugly. I don't care. Do not try to fit in. Me and Nate had this problem. This guy that we know, he's our friend, actually. He's our friend, but like, he just tried to do too much when it came to that high school level, to be honest. We was around some, I guess, like they say, clouded individuals. And this man would try to fit in with these people so
bad.
Oh
my God, it's so crazy.
Like, bro, I don't get it.
Oh
like,
my God.
First of all, clout does not, I don't care one bit about clout. That's just pointless, bro. Like, clout doesn't equal money. And that's what we're chasing.
Clout like, in high school means nothing.
Nothing.
Unless you're a top-ranked high school athlete, it doesn't mean anything, bro. It doesn't.
Still, then it doesn't. Like, just hoop or whatever the fuck you gotta do, but...
Facts.
Do not try to fit. It's annoying, bro. I don't even know where to start on that subject, so... you should know. Just don't fit in.
Yeah, don't try to fit in. That's something in middle school, too. But really, in high school, that is just so cringy. Please don't do it.
You will get ignored so heavy. But they will not acknowledge you one day.
Oh, my God. Yeah. But, yeah, tip 6. Don't try to fit in. Tip number 7. Make allies. Have allies. Make allies. So, what I mean by make allies... I mean, you need to find a group of people that, like, you can trust and you can build shit with. So, like, me and Gavin, we've been cool for a long-ass time. But, like, me, Gavin, a couple, just, like, 2 or 3 other people, those are, like, my allies, right? So, what I say by allies is, like, these are people that, like, help me out, check on me, make sure I'm doing all right, and will help me if I need it type shit. So, yeah, make allies. Make good allies. So let me say the difference between a good ally and a bad ally. So a good friend and a bad friend, basically. So a good friend motivates you, supports you, and will roast you from time to time, will bake you from time to time, but that's all a part of being friends. It's just a joke. But then like your bad allies/friends are people who always bring you down, always make fun of you, and only talk to you when they need something. That's not a friend.
Oh my gosh.
That's a parasite. That's the difference between an ally and a parasite. You need to be careful.
That's a leech.
Yeah, like they're just getting stuff off of you. Like, no, you gotta see those signs right away. That's what, that could be a whole nother video, but you gotta see that right away. But yeah, tip number 7. Have allies. Make allies.
Tip number 8, guys. Relationships will come and go with friends. Plus, I have to include this. Do not be thirsty to date in high school, guys. I'm just saying this. Relationships will come and go with your friends. Now, 8th grade. Savor those years. You're gonna rekindle with them friends, but like, you're gonna grow up and learn that some of them friends that you was hanging out with do not have the same interests as you. Whatever that may be, you're trying to get money, trying to be famous. No, I don't know about the fame part. But with me and Nate, to be honest, we just trying to be young, successful entrepreneurs, just lead by example, trying to be leaders, not followers. We're trying to show people, the young generation, that they can go get it too. And the people that were in 8th grade, the I used to call my friends and whatever, they, nothing wrong with, to be honest, nothing wrong with them at all. Good people. If I see them, we go hang out. It's for sure. But they just don't got the same work ethic and goals that I want to reach. And with that one, yeah, that's all I got to say. Now you got anything to say about that?
About that, yeah, relationships come and go. You just got to learn to let things go, to be honest. For sometimes your friend in 8th grade, maybe he was a good person in 8th grade. Now he's smoking, doing drugs, drinking, doing all types of stuff that you don't need to get into. Especially if you're like an athlete. Bro, you got to focus on what you got to focus on, bro. Like, you can't be trying to, you know what I'm saying? This sometimes you got to let friends go. You know, it's not middle school.
Okay, slash. Don't be thirsty and eager to date in high school. Oh, I can't say this. No. Because, bro, these freshmen or anybody in any grade just be thirsty to date. I'm like, just enjoy y'all years. Like, bro, you do not need to have the responsibility of your feelings and the other person's feelings at stake. Why do that to yourself? You're supposed to be enjoying and getting work done and trying to do better things in life than doing like relationships. But like, I ain't saying relationships are bad, but if you got stuff to focus on, I wouldn't suggest a relationship. Or to be honest, I wouldn't suggest a relationship at all. I think you should just vibe out, have fun, mingle around. Like, it's too early. High school is literally the open world. Like, you're gonna see new people every day. Do not just stick down to one person, have fun, do all that, you know. That's the end of my bullet point. On to point number 9.
All right, point number 9, be a quote unquote good student. So we kind of talked about this before, but I'll go into some detail now. So being a good student isn't just being quiet in class all the time or like having good grades, bro. You got to have a combination. You got to do it all. But see, here's the thing, right?
Got to be a leader too.
Yeah, you got to lead. You got to, you know what I'm saying? You want to stand out in a good way. Because look, the people who have good grades in a class, they will always stand out the most. As long as if you just have a B in a class, in a hard class too, like, it'll make you look good. Not even look good. It'll make you stand out to the teacher. The teacher will notice you're putting work in. So she'll let you get away with some stuff. Like when we were talking about how to skip, in one of our last videos, we were saying how to skip. That's one of the biggest, like, if you want freedom in high school, one of the biggest things you have to do is be a good student. Now, you can be as free as you want. You can be as free as you want if you have no future. You don't want to do nothing with your life. You just want to be a gangbanger.
We've seen plenty of those who wasting their life already. Yeah,
like, you just want to be a gangbanger, all this dumb stuff. I mean, to me, it's not for me, but I mean, some people do it. It's not for me. It's probably not for you either if you're watching this video. But
yeah, but be honest, if you live that life and you was brought up in that life, I can't blame you. You gotta do what you gotta do. But if you have a choice, do not do that. Like, you're stupid.
Yeah, like, just if you do it. Like, let me get into some detail. If you know you're in the fucking suburbs and you're talking about some, oh, you from the trenches, or you like trying to gang
bang, a lot of those false claims,
trying to bang C's, oh my god, GDs, all this, you sending sending hits on people, stuff like that, Gavin, you know what I'm hinting at. That is just stupid. God. Please, guys, please, just focus on what you gotta do. You don't have to
be a good student. Lead by example. Literally, gang is just followers. My gang. People who join gangs are followers. Just off the rip. Be different. Set a new wave. Just be good. Just be good in life. Come on now. Not the art.
Because like the people who were brought up in that life, 9 times out of 10 never wanted to be in that life. Don't want to be in that life, and are probably doing something to try to make it out that life. And you trying to get into it when you're already fortunate. Like, it doesn't make sense.
Living in the where I go, where me and Nate go, we see a lot of this. Kids that have so much potential in life, that are in that street life, that are trying to get in there. Like, you're going backwards in your life. Like, what are you doing?
Fact.
Just stand out, be different, be a good student, lead by example. That's all I gotta say. All right, guys, and the final tip, and probably the most important tip, don't be too serious. Have fun with these 4 years, because they will pass by fast.
Mm.
And that is a fact. Nate are on our third year of high school, and we just got here, pretty much.
Yeah, we feel like we just got here, bro. We feel like we're still freshmen, bro.
I can't believe it.
It's been like, I met this man in 7th grade. What's it been? 4 years went by that quick. 4 years, bro. That is so insane to me. Like, are you gonna have regrets? Yeah, I have some regrets here and there, but I can't live thinking about it. Like, I don't think about it, bro. Like, I know there are things I could have done. I know I think there are things that I could have done better. I know there are people that I shouldn't have trusted, that I shouldn't have talked to, but I'm here now. I'm living. I'm alive. I think I have some good things ahead of me. So, I don't try to think about my regrets. I don't try to, you know what I'm saying, sit here and think about what I could have done better. I just got to keep moving forward.
Me and Nate, we're juniors now. And just thinking about that, like, it's crazy, because I was just in freshman year, bro. I was just coming in. Bro, it's crazy. It's not really, like, going to hit like that this year, because we at home. And we was at home for, like, the ending of last year, too. So it's going to suck a little bit. But, like, and the goal is, like, to be honest, our goal, I'm just trying to make an impact. I'm just trying to leave my impact on this class of 2022 as much as I can. Help out in the community, all that stuff. Like, these 4 years are jetting by. Like, next year, our time is ticking down. And our plan is just to make something happen by the time we're seniors. Hopefully this year we can make some noise on this platform, YouTube, bro. And with our podcast coming up, which is probably already out by the time y'all watching this. So tune in, listen. We got some good episodes for y'all. And next, with that being said, I would say join the club your freshman year, probably. And just build that foundation, you know. Like, try stuff different. Just join the club if you've never had one. Those are pretty fun. I ain't even looked up. Nate, he joined a little club for a little bit, but he was kind of forced to.
Yeah, I was forced to.
Yeah, I don't know his experience. Like, his club, I wouldn't do that stuff. Me personally.
Yeah, I can just go ahead and get into it for y'all. So, our school, the clubs there, none of them really fit my interests. I mean, I like to debate, I like to argue, no cap, I like that a lot, but they didn't have any type of debate club. I wasn't going to be in student government because those people seem to be too condescending to me. I don't like how they talk to people. I just don't like student government, and I don't like being quote-unquote above people. I just like to do my own thing. But with that being said, the club that I did join and I'm still a part of is called the FCCLA. Y'all might know it. I mean, it's cool, you do a bunch of challenges, but none of the challenges really had anything that I liked. So I was pretty much forced into doing challenges I didn't really like. And then COVID happened, so I don't even get to do anything. But yeah, just join a club you want to join. Don't make it so that your parents have to force you, because that is going to suck.
Okay. And with that being said, I would just like to thank y'all for tuning in for this video. And if you haven't checked out our previous videos, it's quarantine. What are you doing? You better go share them videos, watch them all the way through, so we can keep this train rolling. You know what I'm saying? Yes, sir. That being said, thank you, family, and we're out.
Yes, sir. Make sure to check out the podcast, and we might have a Discord up by now. I don't know. But, yeah, peace out.